This year in the American Society of Hematology virtual meeting, we had two very interesting presentations from the Sierra trial. So the Sierra trial is a trial sponsored by Actinium Pharmaceuticals, where they are demonstrating that a conditioning regimen with radio-labeled anti-CD45 monoclonal antibody, or what's called Iomab, can produce remissions that are durable in a safe and very effective manner in patients with active acute leukemia who are undergoing an allogeneic transplant. So this is a very interesting phase three design where patients with active disease who have failed either primary induction therapy or have relapsed after initial therapy with acute myeloid leukemia who are over the age of 55 get randomized to either proceed straight to a conditioning regimen with Iomab, which is a radionucleotide, and then followed by a reduced intensity conditioning regimen, fludarabine and low-dose TBI, versus a variety of reinduction regimens. The primary endpoint is a CR duration of more than 6 months. So what's interesting in the two presentations is one, that the group that was randomized to the Iomab arm had significantly less risk of neutropenic fevers because there was much less gastrointestinal toxicities that were seen in this group of patients, which resulted in less sepsis. And then the other very interesting abstract that was presented again by Dr. Buglarga Yugurso from Memorial Sloan-Kettering was that the hematologic toxicities were significantly less in this group of patients, that their duration of neutropenia, the requirements of transfusions were significantly less. The trial is 75%, more than 75% accrued. It's expected to finish in 2021. The primary endpoint has obviously not read out yet. That is durable CRs of more than 6 months, and we're expecting to see it. But I think the two promises this had for a very challenging group of patients, patients with active acute leukemia, in which many centers are not taking them to transplant because of the poor outcomes that are associated with it. This shows that this really fits an unmet medical need.